Okay, so this is the solution to the example problem in homework number 3, and this will also serve as a lesson on the problem-solving method known as GRASP. So GRASP is an acronym. The G stands for the givens, and in any problem, there should be some values that are given to you. Please always list them with their units. So in science, the number 4 is pretty much undefined. In science, not sure what happened there. Anyway, in science, this number has a value, but we don't know much about it until it has units. So is it 4 grams, or is it 4 milliliters, etc. Okay? R is basically what are we needing to do here? What's required? So in this problem, the example problem, we're trying to find the density. So I would simply write down D for density equals question mark. Analysis is, the A is for analysis, and that is what formula do we need to use? What do we need to do to solve this problem? And in this case, we need to use the density formula, which is density equals mass divided by volume. S is to actually do the work. So now is when you plug in your values. Let's go ahead and do the density problem. So let's go back up to the givens. So the mass is 20 grams, and the volume, yes, let me make a little room here. So, excuse me. And the volume is 40 milliliters, okay? So down here to do the work, so density equals my mass of 20 grams divided by my volume of 40 milliliters. Notice how I'm always listing the units with my values. 20 divided by 40, well, I know the zeros cancel, the tens cancel out. 2 divided by 4 is 1/2. We generally don't use fractions in scientific reporting, so this would become 0.5, and my units for density in this case are grams per milliliter. Now, the last step is the P, which stands for paraphrase. And so what you do here is you use the solution in a sentence. It's also a good time to check your work. So does this make sense, that an object with a density or mass of 20 grams and a volume of 40 milliliters has a density of only 0.5 grams per milliliter? Yeah, I think it does, because if the mass is about half the volume, then it would make sense that the density is 0.5. So we're going to just go ahead and restate that in the sentence. Say the density of the object is 0.5 grams per milliliter. Now, I don't know if you're interested in this yet or not, but when we mark problems like this on future evaluations or other assessments, here's where all the marks are awarded. So there are, in almost all these problems, there will be 1 knowledge mark, 1 communication mark, and 3 application marks available. And so here's where you earn them. It's pretty cool, at least I think so. First of all, you get an application mark for simply writing down the givens, and also for deciding what you need to work towards or what we're trying to solve for. So if you do the givens and what we need to solve for, you just earn a mark. If you suss out the correct formula to use, you earn another application mark. And then if you set the problem up and show your workings, in this case, there's not much to do besides set it up. You could obviously have done this on a calculator. But showing us the setup, if not any algebra that needs to be done, any type of mathematics or any other problem solving, that earns you another application mark. Finally, the knowledge mark. The only mark based upon the correct answer is the knowledge mark. So if you got 0.5, you earned a knowledge mark. And then if you showed it with the correct units, and in this case the correct units are grams per milliliter, because that's what the mass and the volume were given in, now you've earned the communication mark. So I think it's a pretty cool setup. It rewards you for using a problem-solving method. And honestly, even if you get the problem wrong, like if you did it upside down and you got 2 grams per milliliter, you would only have lost the knowledge mark. If you did everything else correctly except for the mathematics, you would have earned 4 out of 5 marks. Okay? All right, so that's our first screencast lesson. That's how to use the GRASP method while solving a density problem.